Hello and welcome to Controllers Tech. Today we will see how to interface GP2Y0A41SK0F, an infrared sharp sensor with STM32. This IR sharp sensor uses the infrared to measure the distance of an object. The sensor is a combination of position-sensitive detector, an infrared emitting diode, and a signal processing circuit. The device outputs the voltage corresponding to the detection distance, so it can also be used as a proximity sensor. It can measure distances from 4 cm to 30 cm. The sensor is an analog output type, so we can measure the voltage corresponding to the distance by using the ADC of the MCU. The supply voltage needs to be 5 volts, but I have tested it with 3.3 volts, and it works just fine. We will check the other things in this datasheet in a while. Let's take a look at the connection first. The sensor is powered with 3.3 volts from the MCU itself. The signal pin is connected to PA0, which is basically the ADC 1 channel 0 pin. That is all for the connection. Let's create a new project in Cube IDE. I am using STM32F103C8. Let's give some name to the project and click Finish. I am starting with the clock setup first. I am selecting an external crystal for the clock. The board has 8 MHz crystal on it, and we will run the system at maximum 72 MHz. Now go to the ADC1, and enable channel 0. You can see the pin PA0 got configured as the ADC pin. I am leaving the configuration to default, so I will use the ADC single channel in the blocking mode. You can check the video on the top right corner to understand ADC modes in detail. There is some issue with the clock. Let's reduce the ADC clock to a reasonable frequency. Alright, generate the project again. Let's define a variable to store the calculated distance value. Now create a function to measure the distance. Here we will first measure the ADC value, and then convert it to the distance. I am using the ADC in the polling mode. The F103 has 12-bit ADC, therefore we will use the 16-bit variable to store the ADC value. The default ADC reference voltage is 3.3 volts. We will use this 3.3 volts to convert the ADC value to the voltage format. Now this converted voltage can be used to calculate the distance of the object from the sensor. But there is no formula provided in the datasheet for the same. We can use the graph to figure out a relation between the voltage and the distance. This is the graph of equation y equals ax plus b, where the y-axis represents the output voltage, and the x-axis represents the distance of the object. We can use two different points on the graph to calculate the constants a and b. And then use the constants, along with the output voltage to calculate the distance of the object. There is one more graph, which is more like a straight line. The graph is plotted between the output voltage on the y-axis, and the x-axis represents the inverse of the distance, along with some offset. I will use this particular graph to find the relation between the output voltage and the distance. Assuming that this is indeed a straight line, let's calculate the slope of this line first. We need to take two sets of coordinates on this line. The first coordinate will be 0.15 on the x-axis, and 0.65 on the y-axis. Similarly, the second coordinate will be 0.15 on the x-axis, and 1.95 on the y-axis. Let's use these two coordinates to calculate the slope of this line. It comes out to be 13. Now you can calculate the value of the constant in the equation of line y equals mx plus c. The constant will be 0. So we have the line equation as y equals 13x. Although this line remains straight for most of the distances, it is not quite the same below 5 cm. But that is alright, we can have a small error in that part. The x-axis here is basically the inverse of the distance. So we need to rearrange the formula to calculate the distance L, as shown in the image. Let's test it. Suppose we got the output voltage of 1.2 volts from the ADC. Now we will use the rearranged formula to calculate the distance. First, divide the value 13 by the voltage output. Now subtract the constant value 0.42. We got the distance around 10.4. If you check the graph, this is approximately the same as expected. So we can use this rearranged formula to calculate the distance. Let's use the formula to calculate the distance inside the measure distance function. The calculated value will be stored in the distance variable. Now inside the main function, call the ADC calibration function once. Inside the while loop, we will measure the distance every 500 milliseconds. Let's build and debug the project now. Add the distance variable in the live expression, and run the debugger. You can see the device on the bottom right corner. I am placing the object at 4 cm, and you can see the distance being shown as 4.5 cm. As I mentioned, there is some error below 5 cm, because the graph is not actually a straight line in this region. Now the object is at 5 cm, and the distance being shown is 5.3 cm. I have placed the object at 6 cm now. The object is at 7 cm now. You can see the measured distance is approximately the same as the object distance. The object is now placed at 14 cm from the sensor. It is 17 cm away right now. The object is now 26 cm away, and we are still getting a pretty good measurement. So the sensor works pretty well, even at higher ranges. Although it seems unreliable around 29 to 30 cm, but it works fine for the rest of the distance range. There are other sharp sensors that work for higher distance ranges, so you can check them if you need. This particular sensor works between 4 to 30 cm, and it does the job well. That is it for the video. I hope you understood how to interface the IR sharp sensor with STM32. You can download the project from the link in the description. Leave comments in case of any doubt. Keep watching, and have a nice day ahead.